praise the name of the Lord. This is the day the Lord has made. We rejoice in the day that God has made for us. And I'm happy. Today I'm happy because I know the cloud of corona is coming to an end. It's coming to a halt. And God, that has begun a good work in our lives, is able to sustain us. I want us to just rejoice and just thank God this morning as we receive the word of God very briefly. Today is very brief. And I want us to pray against the spirit of limitation. And this is our prayer. My Father, I thank you because the spirit of limitation is not my Lord. Let's go against the spirit of limitation. Every limitation in your life, any limitation, financial limitation, physical limitation, mental limitation, sight limitation, wherever you are limited, I pray that God shall kill the power of limitation in the name of Jesus. Father, we lift your name and honor you. Thank you for our viewers that are watching us from Doxa Television, from all over the world. The Lord, the spirit of limitation shall not become their master. We rise against the giant of limitation. We rise against, Lord, where our heart feels like they cannot leap over the hurdle. And Lord, I pray we are able to leap over every hurdle of this life, every hurdle of challenges, financial hurdles, oh God, sickness hurdles and difficulties. And Lord, that our spirit, Lord, rejoices in you, for you give us the ability. I pray that, Lord, not power against our hurdles, the spirit of limitation shall, Lord, keep us down. But Lord, we raise our voices to declare we are able. We are, Lord, ready and able to overcome. We bless your name. Lord, bless us this morning, even as you open our eyes and our ears, Lord, to understand the season we are in. Like the sons of Issachar, they understood the season and they knew what to do. May you give us that revelation that, Lord, we shall walk in revelation and not by sight, in Jesus' name. Amen. Our second prayer again is that, Lord, today I declare total freedom from the spirit of limitation. An unwanted detention. Unwanted detention. Spirit of limitation brings detention. And I pray that you need to pray, God, I am free from limitation and unwanted detention. I shall not be detained. You know, when you are limited, you are detained. And when you are detained, then you are not able to accomplish much that God has given to us. That's why people cannot accomplish many things in a season. Because in one season, 12 months a year, 365 days in a year, you are able to do many things. You are able to go abroad. You are able to build a house. You are able to buy a car. You are able to own a house. You are able to take your children to school. You are able to do business. You are able to, you know, there's a lot you can accomplish. But when you are operating in a spirit of limitation, then you are detained. Your mind is detained. You start seeing impossibilities. You start seeing that I cannot make it. There are things that are difficult. No one can help me. I can attain that. You start seeing mountains. And let me tell you, there are no mountains. It's the spirit of limitation. Our prayer is today, God, I declare total freedom from the spirit of limitation and unwanted detention in the name of Jesus. Father, we lift our voices right now against the spirit of limitation, against principalities and forces of darkness that, Lord, have stood to bind our life, that has stood to detain our mind, to detain our ability to see that, Lord, we cannot see the possibilities in God. And I declare in Jesus' name, I am not a captive of limitation. I'm not a captive of limitation, oh God, and spiritual detention in Jesus' name. I command my freedom, oh God. I break every fetters this morning. I cancel the powers of darkness, every fetters in my spirit, every fetters in my finances, every fetters in my life, every fetters in my mind, every fetters in the church, every fetters in the government. Lord, we break the chains in the name of Jesus and declare freedom of mind, freedom of resources, freedom of understanding, freedom to go up to different parts of the world. In the name of Jesus, Lord, we break forth, and we pray for this nation that, Lord, you shall also not limit the nation of Kenya. That, Lord, now people are incapacitated, and I pray that, Lord, the spirit of lockdown, the spirit of limitation has come, and Lord, forcefully to the nation, I pray that we shall overcome limitation in the name of Jesus. The spirit of bondage, oh God, we break this spirit in Jesus' precious name. Amen. We break the spirit of limitation in the mighty name of Jesus. We shall not be limited In the name of Jesus. Now, the last prayer point is that you strange forces holding you down, and command them to release you. Strange forces. There are strange forces that hold people down. Now, you know when you are supposed to arise and do something, you feel lazy. You feel you don't want to. You don't even when the opportunities are ready for you. Even when the opportunities are calling out, that come out and receive the opportunities, you still feel that you cannot. You still feel that there are principalities. There are forces that holds people down. Declare today, any force that is holding me down, break by fire in the name of Jesus. Declare any invisible power holding me down, break now in the name of Jesus. Let's go before the Lord and pray. Let's pray. And against the forces of darkness, Father, I pray every power that holds me down, holds my mind down, when it is my time of blessing, when it is my time of resourcefulness, when it's my time to receive your blessing, I break this power by fire in the name of Jesus. I declare fire. I declare fire. I declare the fire of the Lord. I declare the fire of the Lord. I declare fire. Brasha katala baba reketara naba. I break the fire, the forces of evil against that holds us down. In the name of Jesus, that we are not able to take opportunities. We shall take godly opportunities. We shall take godly opportunities in Jesus' precious name. Amen. Amen. Let's go to our subject this morning. And last two days ago, I was talking about dreaming bigger. Bigger dream. How to dream. Because it is necessary that you dream bigger. And I came to a place, I said, imagination is greater than anything in the world. Because people that imagine are people that are able to rule the world. People that imagine us. You know, you imagine doing something and it shall come to pass. Imagination rules the world. That is what was told by Napoleon. Napoleon said, imagine people that with great imagination rule the world. And I said again, daydreamers are more dangerous than night dreamers. A person that dreams in the day are people that are strategic in their vision. And they are able to escalate and move and scale their vision to take on. You know, just imagine I'm just saying from a negative point of view. A person who imagines to steal, he looks at people going and says, I want that jacket. And he starts to imagine how he'll get it. He starts to strategize how he'll get it. And he starts pursuing the person in the jacket just to get the jacket out. That's a dangerous person. That a person who dreams in the night and forget what they have dreamt. And again, we look at 7 steps to identify the dream. How do we identify the dream of God in your life? We said inward conviction, prophetic confirmation, scriptural evidence, circumstantial evidence, God's counsel, God's peace, and God's provision. And I give you 5 types of people in the church that are stuck. And they're struggling in life, yet they're in the church. Now, number one, I give you that people, number one, people without dreams. There are people who are frustrated, have no agenda. Their language is, if only I can be like so and so. If only I can have this. That's their language. And I said, these kind of people are talkers. Many of them are talkers. They are prideful and they are dream killers. So you need also to be careful on them. You know, they depend on what they see. It's not what they are really out to follow and to get. Number two, we say low dreamers. Low dreamers, not zealous of God. They are not motivated. They are not there. They fear accountability and they fear criticism and they are afraid of failure. They sell their dream to other people. That's the second group of people in the church. And the third group of people in the church is wrong dreamers. That from Proverbs 16:25. Now, these are people who are opportunists. No, they exploit others. They ask, is it worthy to do that? You know, there are people that are of this kind of nature. They don't allow correction. They are rigid. They are adamant. You know, they are harsh. They are brutal. They are people that are uncorruptible. So these are the kind of people that are in the church. And number four, vague dreams. Vague. That is not clear. Not clear vision. Now, and this I said, they die frustrated. They die in frustration. And I said again, they live a bitter life. A life of confusion because their dreams are not clear. And then you must have a purpose in your heart for you to be a giant or to make a stride in this life. You must have a purpose. That means know your purpose. Know why God created you to do. And you have an assignment that you must accomplish. Number five, I said people with God's dream. Now, these are great and special people that expect from their, they do things from the ordinary. You know, they become greater. As God lifts their vision up, God lifts them also. So that when their vision are up there, they are also up there. If you ask them, what special are they in you? Let me tell you, great people are not special people. They are just people that have been sticking to their vision and, you know, clinging to their vision and moving their vision and driving their vision. And when their vision becomes greater, they become great with the vision. They are not special people. They don't have wings to fly like angels. No, they are just ordinary people who are clinging to their vision, and their vision have taken them very far. The problem is that many people are bought their vision. Many people are copycats. They copy what others are doing. They want to do like so and so. And they, you know, they run. They compete with the people. Let me tell you, never compete with anybody. The race is set for you. You've got to run your race. Everyone must run their race. And I pray today that you shall run your race in this life in Jesus' name. Now, let me give you seven steps to bigger dream. Seven steps to a bigger dream. Now, that is, how do you catch your vision? I have seven steps for you. There's one question that they asked before we go to number one. One question that somebody asked. He said, are you an eagle or are you a hen? There's a difference between a hen and an eagle. And let me tell you, hens fight over small things just in their vicinity. They never raise their heads to see the sky. But eagles look at the sky and they desire to fly into the sky very far. It is the only bird that flies over 15,000 feet or 26,000 feet above sea level. But hens don't. And I pray, what are you? Ask yourself, am I a hen or an eagle? Because if you're an eagle, then your eyes must look very far. Don't look at things that are just next to you. Look at far. Look at things that are far. Look at your five years to come. Look at your 10 years to come. Look at your 15 years to come. Look at the end of your life. What will you have achieved? You must have a vision for that direction, that you are able to accomplish vision no matter what. The little you get, you put toward vision. The people you work with are people toward your vision. And I pray you will reach your destination. Number one, open your mind to God. So the first thing to bigger dreams. Number one, open your mind to God. Or in other words, be inspired by the word of God. Be inspired by the word of God. Now, don't be moved by what you hear, but what you believe. Do not be moved by what you hear, by what you believe. Do not be moved by what you hear, but what you believe. That is key. Let me give you Proverbs 28:26. Proverbs 28:26. Now look at Proverbs 28:26. It says, for he who trusts himself is a fool. He who trusts himself is a fool. But he who walks in wisdom is kept safe. So do not trust in yourself. Trust in the Lord. Be inspired by the word of God. Then the second scripture, Proverbs 2:6. Proverbs 2:6 and 7. Let's read the two of them and get this wisdom from that book. He says, for the Lord gives wisdom, from his mouth comes knowledge and understanding. God gives wisdom, and from his mouth comes knowledge and understanding. Give us verse 7. It says, he holds victory in store for the upright. He is a shield to those who walk in blameless. Now, he holds victory in the store. Let me tell you, when you walk with God, he holds victory for you. I pray, may you walk in that victory. May you walk in that revelation. May you walk in that vision. May you stand in that dream and you become greater with God in your dream in the name of Jesus. Now, listen to this. What is God's will for your ministry? And what is God's will for your life? Don't listen to talkers and rumors and move with people, because bad company corrupts morals. Bad company corrupts morals. Don't walk with rumors. Don't walk with people who are talkers. Look at people that have accomplished things. In the book of 1 Corinthians, give us 1 Corinthians 15:33. 1 Corinthians 15:33. wonderful. He says, do not be misled. Bad company corrupt good character. But look at your friends. Who are people that surround your life? Because they matter. They determine your next level. They determine your next move. They determine where you are going. I pray in the name of Jesus. May you be able to look high. May you be able to look ahead. May you be able to accomplish much. May God give you strength. May you be able to look at your surrounding. Don't listen to talkers. Listen to people that have accomplished things. So that means your friends must be people who are going your direction. So you cannot have people going your opposite direction. Have people that are going to your next direction. Number two, the second way, second step to bigger dream. Do some research. Do some research. Before you engage in business, do research. That we call information layout. Do what we call information layout. There are many people today who are taking their pension money and wanting to do business without consultation, without spiritual covering. I tell you, you cannot make it. Brethren, it's difficult. Let me tell you, if you have not been in the game, you cannot win the game alone. You need a coach. You need a blessing. You need a training. You need to be empowered. You need information. If you don't get the information, then you will never make it. You'll die frustrated. Why? The business will kill all your money. You cannot come from a formal sector where you are employee and come into the business empire and wanting to become a leader and wanting to win the race. You cannot win. Number one, you must have a covering. Who is covering your life? Who is covering? Who is your spiritual covering? Who is speaking to your life? Who is prayed for you to begin the business? Who is your coach? Who is coaching you in that business? Do you know the risk that it takes? Do you know where to begin? No, you cannot take 1 million and come and put them in a business, open a business of pain or open a hardware without this kind of, let me tell you, information layout, information. Do research. In Proverbs, give us Proverbs 13:15. If you can, please, Proverbs 13:15. It's very, very important for you to understand. Proverbs 13:15 says, good understanding wins favor. But the way of the unfaithful is hard. Good understanding win favor. That means you must understand what you want to do. Number, go to verse 16. 16. Go to 16. He says, every prudent man acts out of knowledge, but a fool exposes his folly. A prudent man acts of... Now, you must act with knowledge. A prudent man acts out of knowledge. Number 17. Go to verse 17. He says, a wicked messenger falls into trouble, but a trustworthy envoy brings healing. So a wicked messenger falls into trouble, but a trustworthy envoy brings healing. That means you must come as an envoy from your place of work to business. I pray that before you engage in what you're about to start, seek advice. Seek advice. Don't just come and think that because you have money, you can do anything. Because you have money, that... Let me tell you, the earth can swallow your money. Your money can fly wings and go away. Please understand the spiritual order of things. Because in every game, there are rules. If you don't engage into the rules of business, then you cannot be a businessman. If you don't engage in the rules of working, then you cannot have the ethics, the works of ethics. You need understanding. I'm telling you, you need understanding. And you cannot just become from everywhere and become a pastor. You'll con people. Let me tell you, everything is about God and his assignment. You've got to identify the assignment and look at the points. There are calling points that God has given you, and there are men that are your bridges. You must look for your bridge that somebody who can you can sit on his shoulders and cross the bridge. Don't cross the bridge alone. Others are opportunists. They want to take advantage of others. Let me tell you, you're going no far. I pray today that this can be an eye opener for your life. Don't waste time with things that don't matter. Do not waste time with things that do not matter. Look at things that matter. And, you know, people engage in nonsense. You look at yourself, you ask yourself, why are you engaging in things that do not matter? Whatever does not matter to your life, to your vision, don't engage yourself. Don't engage. Don't fight the battles that are not yours. No. Get out of battles that are not yours. Only fight your battles.
Ask what do I need to know first. This is a very important question. Ask yourself, what do I need to know first, so that you are able to get to where you need to go. And if you cannot get the answer to that question, read books, use videos, go to seminars, ask the experts, and you'll get the answer to that question. Number three, ask for advice. Ask for advice. That means consult. Consultation is the mother of renovation. Now you need to consult. Consult the experts so that you can be able to conquer. Now in Proverbs 24 verse 6, go to Proverbs 24, 6. And look, let's look a few scriptures. It says, for waging war, you need guidance. And for victory, many advisors. For you to wage war, you need guidance. And for your victory, you need many guidance. That means you need special guide. Go to the next one, verse 7. It says, wisdom is too high for a fool. In the assembly at the gate, he has nothing to say. Therefore, do not act the fool. Otherwise, you will lose everything that you have. Proverbs 20, verses 18. I'll read quite a number of scriptures. Proverbs 20, 18. It says, make plans by seeking advice. And if you wage war, obtain guidance. Do you see again? Seek advice. Seek advice. That means ask for advice. You are not a fool to make consultation. Go to Proverbs 18, verse 15. Proverbs 18, 15. Proverbs 18. Go to 18. He says, the heart of a discerning acquires knowledge. The heart of a discerning man acquires knowledge. And the ears of a wise seek out. The ears of a wise person seek out. Your ears must be alert and your heart must be able to seek that knowledge in the name of Jesus. Don't be a fan or a spectator because you are not a partaker. If you become a fan, you will like watching things happen. You know, there are three kinds of people. There are those who watch things happen. There are those who see things happen and they ask what happened. And there are those who make things happen. It depends on what category are you. Be a person who makes things happen, not a spectator. Or otherwise you'll become an undertaker. And the next point is that be committed to the vision or your dream. Be committed to your vision or your dream. Be committed to your vision or your dream. Now, use your knees to hold your vision. That means pray. Use your prayer. Pray for your vision. Pray for your dream. Now, that is from Proverbs 18, 15. Proverbs, go to Proverbs. It says, the heart of the discerning acquires knowledge and the ears of the wise seeks it out. So you need to seek knowledge. You need to inquire. Consultation. Consult. I again say consult. There are many people, and especially people that are coming out of employment, many people that have got given pension, they come in their dream world. You know, you are in your dream world. That one day I'll do a business. One day I'll do this. One day I'll do this. One day I'll build a house. You cannot build a house without consultation. My friend, you need spiritual covering. You need consultation. You need a coach. You need to understand. That money, when that money gets out of your hand, it never comes back if you don't get a coach. Because many people have burned their fingers. And when you burn your fingers, you live life of frustration and crying the rest of your life because you never consulted. No, I look at many people in life. They go to buy vehicles. And you buy a car and you don't ask yourself, what is the purpose of the car that I'm buying? What condition am I in? Why do I need a car? And which purpose is it going to work for me? So you buy a car in a few, three months later, you are realized you didn't need that kind of a vehicle. You need a different vehicle. That was not a car of your dream or that cannot do what you want to do. And therefore, now you start selling it. Let me tell you, those are mistakes you need to avoid. Seek consultation. Now, it says, experience of others is an investment to you. Experience of others is an investment. Look for people that have experienced. There are people that have made mistakes we are making now. Please don't make. Don't reinvent the wheel. There are people that have made the same mistakes and they have learned. They can give you free advice. And you can become a man on the top because of people's advice. Now, who else can help you? Go to your pastor. Go to your pastor. Your pastor is very key. He's your coach. Go to your pastor and get advice. Number four, establish priorities in this life. Establish priorities. What are your priorities in this life? What are your priorities? Because we keep doing the same things and repeating the same things for the rest of our lives, doing the same things all over again. You do the same. Look at what you do. Look at your life and what you do every day. You do, it's like you are recycling yourself every day, doing the same things, sleeping in the same position, you know, just standing there. You know, are you not tired? Hallelujah. Establish priorities. What are your priorities? Some of the priorities are painful. Some of the priorities demand your attention. Some of your priorities demand your effort. Therefore, you must put effort in everything you do. That means refuse to do ordinary things every day. Because somebody said, if you keep doing the same things every day, you get the same results. Now, you need to do something you have not done. That means engage yourself to things you have not done. Let your body feel that I'm doing something I've never done. That every day there is something new that you are doing. And in the doing of the new things, then God brings in dimensions of and levels of the output you have never experienced. If you need new things, do extraordinary things. If you need ordinary things, put in an ordinary effort. Let me tell you, you must go beyond the ordinary effort and do things. That's when you get different results. You must be tired of doing the same things every day. At times I get tired of sleeping the same bed everywhere, the same position every night, turning the same way. I feel bad. Sometimes I want to change my bed every day that I feel there's something different. Why? I love doing different things. I don't want to do things the same way I do this. Even eating, you don't keep eating the same way. You eat differently and eat different things. And do if you are tired, drink water and sleep and pray. And you see the difference. Your body will tell you, today there is a difference. Because when you are hungry at night, you are able to tell your body, shut up. It's a different day. It's a different style in the name of Jesus. What am I saying? Establish priorities. What are your priorities? Don't spend money buying the same things every day. You eating the same things, buying the same things. Please establish priorities in this life. Now, the principle of selection, we call it the principle of selection. That now we are choosy. Go for the best. Be choosy. Go for the best. Be choosy. And I love somebody who said, ukitaka kula nguruwe, kula alienona. So be choosy. Don't just go for everything. That is, be a vessel of quality. Don't buy simple things every day, but be a vessel of quality. I pray that your quality shall increase. Your quality shall be different. And the other point is, don't be driven by urgent things. Go for important things. Don't be driven by urgent things. Go for important things. There are important attentions that you need to give to your life. There are important things that you need to give into your life. Don't be driven by urgent things. Go for important things. It is not how different you are, but how effective you are. It is not how efficient you are. It is not how efficient you are in life. It is how effective you are in life. That is what makes a difference. The good is the enemy of the best. The good is the enemy of the best. Remember that in your life. The good is the enemy of the best. So for you to produce the best, there's an enemy of that best. I pray that you shall change your direction. Number five. Let's go to number five. Number five. And now, evaluate the costs every time. Evaluate the cost every time. That means evaluation level in your life is very important. Every time, evaluate the cost. What is the cost of everything you do? What is the cost and what are the returns? Evaluate the cost and look at the returns. Because if you don't do evaluation in life, then you will waste. It will be a waste of life, a waste of time. I pray that you'll keep evaluating the costs and look at the return. Now, for example, if what you are doing today, have you evaluated the costs and the returns of what you'll get from what you do? Is it sustainable? Is it achievable? Is it a blessing? Now, you've got to evaluate the costs, evaluation level, and look at the returns. So that whatever effort you put in, the effort and the returns must be equivalent. Proverbs 20:25. Quickly, let's look at Proverbs 20:25. It says, it is a trap for a man to dedicate something rashly and only later to consider his vows. Don't dedicate, don't be rashy in making things evaluate the cost. Go to Luke 14:28. Luke 14:28. It's very important when Jesus was giving a valuation. Look at, he says, suppose one of you want to build a tower. Will he not first sit down and estimate the cost to see if it's enough money to complete it? Now, you need to look at the cost. That means evaluation. For if he lays the foundations and is not able to finish it, everyone who sees it will ridicule him. 30. Saying, this fellow began to build and was not able to finish. Now, he says, or purpose, or suppose a king is about to go to war against another king. Will he not first sit down and consider whether he is able to win with the 10,000 men or to oppose the one coming against him with the 25? If he is not able, he will send delegation while the other is still on the long way off, and he will ask for terms of peace. That means you need to evaluate. Evaluate, evaluation is very important. Don't rush in making decision. Don't rush in making decision. And even in getting married, choose for a wife. Look for a husband. Evaluate. Number 6, plan for problems. Plan for problems. Problems. Always in life, there are problems. No matter the levels you are in, there are always problems. And you need to plan for the problem. A level of preparation. You need to prepare. Proverbs 20 verses 18. Let's look again at Proverbs 20:18 and look at what it says. Proverbs 20:18. It says, make plans by seeking advice. If you wage war, obtain guidance. That means seek for guidance as you prepare for. Go to Proverbs 22, verse 3. Proverbs 22, verse 3. Maybe we repeat it again. It says, a prudent man sees danger and comes and takes refuge. But a simple keeps going and suffer for it. Verse 4. Humility and the fear of the Lord brings wealth and honor and life. Now, it's very important that we keep in humility. Because when we are humble, God exalts us. Humility brings exaltation. Now, we must humble ourselves. And now, there are a few things we need to ask yourself. Expect the best, but plan for the worst. Expect the best, but plan for the worst. Ask what is going wrong. You must ask yourself, what can go wrong if I do 1, 2, 3? Always think for the problems and ask yourself, what can go wrong? What will I do? No, anticipate for the problems and look for solutions. Anticipate for the problems and look for solutions. So many people don't do that. They just engage. When the problem comes, they are just struck like lightning has come, and they are stuck in the rest of their life. I pray that you are able to anticipate for problem and look for solution. And finally, be willing to risk. Be willing to risk. Be willing to risk. We call it confrontational level. Confront the trouble. Confront. Confront the trouble. Proverbs 29:25. Proverbs 29:25. Go to Proverbs. It says, fear of a man will prove to be a snare. But whoever trusts in the Lord is kept safe. So our trust is in the Lord. Therefore, face trouble and face the mountains. Face every challenge that comes. Don't allow it. When it comes in a molehill, if you ignore it tomorrow, it will be a hill or a mountain that you cannot solve. I pray, face head on. Face your troubles head on and don't give them a chance. We go again to Proverbs 14:26. Proverbs 14:26. Proverbs 14:26. It says, he who fears the Lord has a secure fortress, and for his children it will be a refuge. Go to 26:27. Now the fear of the Lord is a fountain of life, turning a man from the snares of death. Therefore, when we go into the Lord, when we seek the guidance of God, we are covered. We are covered. Now, the fear of the Lord is a fountain of life, but turning from a man is a snare. So, don't trust upon yourself. Trust upon the Lord. Hallelujah. Are your fears just, sometimes you ask yourself, are your fears justified? Are your fears justified? Are your fears justified? Do it now. Don't wait. You know, I this is what I believe in. When God has already inspired something in your life and tells you to go and do something, do it. Don't ask your neighbor. Your neighbor, God never spoke to your neighbor. If you would have spoken to your neighbor, they would have come to tell you. But if God has spoken to you, there are things that God has spoken to you and you only. You obey the voice. You have heard the inner voice. Do it. That's why I remember Mary in the wedding of Cana in the John chapter 3. He said, whatever he tells you to do, do it. No questions. Do it. So I pray. You must do what God has given you to do. Proverbs 16:3. Commit to the Lord your plan. Proverbs 16:3. It says, commit to the Lord whatever you do, and your plans shall succeed. Commit to the Lord whatever your plans are, and you shall succeed. Be bold, be productive, and be a doer. Be bold, be productive, and be a doer. That means be a person that is able to do things. Do what you are not able to do, and you will see. Tough times don't last, but tough people do. I want you to be a tough woman, a tough man. In these times, be tough. Don't be swallowed by whatever happens. Hallelujah. Now, let me give you the last one. 6 ways on how to apply the lesson. How do you apply it? I just mentioned a few things, and then I'll be out of your way. It says 6 ways to apply this lesson. Number one, by prayer. By prayer. Prayer and meditation. Pray and meditate. Prayer and meditation. Number two, acting on the teaching. That is, practice what you have heard. Practice what you have heard. Very important. But you are not a hearer only, but a doer. Practice what you have heard. Number three, teaching others. That is, whatever you have been entrusted in, train others with it. And number four, by having long-term strategy to implement. Have a long-term strategy to implement. Have a long-term strategy to implement. Number five, be sharing with your wife. Share, discuss with your husband. Discuss with your wife. Discuss this with your wife. And you'll find that you'll get, you'll take your dream to the next level. And number six, changing willingly. Change your attitude willingly. Change your attitude. Be unique. Be different. Be unique. Be different. Be unique. Be different in your life. Change your attitude willingly, because attitude determines your altitude. Attitude determines your altitude. That means the height above. So the higher you go is determined by your attitude. I pray. Now, ask yourself these questions. Why do dreams abort? Why do dreams abort? Now, let me finish by telling you the 5 F's that makes your dream abort. 5 F's. 5 F's that makes your dreams abort. Number one, we call it the family can abort your vision. Number one is family. The family can abort your vision. Did you see that? You can give the story of Joseph and their brothers. They aborted this dream. Number two, friends can abort your vision. That means do not tell your friends your vision before the time. That means don't expose yourself. Now, Mark 5:35. Keep quickly. Give us Mark the 5:35 and look at that. Mark 5:35. Very important. While Jesus was still speaking, some men came from the house of Jairus, saying the synagogue ruler, your daughter is dead. They said, why bother the teacher? Go to the next one. He says, ignoring what they said, Jesus told the synagogue ruler, don't be afraid, just believe. Don't be afraid. And I've come to tell you, don't be afraid of your friends. Just believe in the Lord. Hallelujah. Psalms 1:1, very important. Look at Psalm 1:1. There's an important information you need to understand. Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked. Blessed is the man who does not walk in the counsel of the wicked. Don't walk in the counsel of the wicked. Or even stand. Look at that. He says, or stand in the way of the sinners, sit in the seat of the mockers. Don't walk in the counsel of the, he says, but delight in the law of the Lord. On his law, he meditates day and night. Verses 3, he is like a tree planted by the streams of water, which yields its fruits in season, and whose leaf does not wither. Whatever he does prospers. your friends can be a big problem. Now, therefore, you look at the composition of your friends. If your friends are not going your direction, delete them from your life. Delete them from your life. Number three, fatigue and exhaustion. Fatigue and exhaustion. Fatigue and exhaustion can kill your vision. Now, this will make your vision small, but don't abort it. Don't abort your idea. Fatigue and exhaustion. So I said family, friends, fatigue, and exhaustion can also abort your vision. Number four, failure. Failure can also bring frustration. You look at Joshua chapter 7, you find the story of Achan and the failure that brought to Israel. Sin can bring failure. Doubt can bring failure. So again, failure can be a cause. But look at the cause of failure. It is sin. Committing sin can bring failure in your life. Now, failure in education or failure in doing things and you disqualify yourself, I pray you shall not disqualify yourself whether you have been to school or not. Let me tell you, it is not only those who are in school that succeed. Everybody is given an opportunity by God. The Bible tells us in Ecclesiastes 9:11, it is a chance for all. A chance for all. God gives a chance for all of us. So, look at the scripture. He says, I've seen something else under the sun. The race is not to the swift or the battle to the strong. Nor does food come to the wise or wealth to the brilliant or favor to the innocent, to the learned. But time and chance happens. Therefore, you have a chance to do your great things. So, do not allow failure. Don't allow failure to your life. And number five, fear. Two kinds of fear. There is what we call holy fear and unholy fear. Which one are you? The holy fear makes you fear sin and become prosperous. Unholy fear puts you into bondage and the enemy will take your life. Don't compare yourself with other people. You are unique. Don't compare yourself with other. Please don't compare yourself with somebody else. Your fingerprints are unique than anyone on earth. Your eyes are different from anybody. That means if your eyes can be different from 47 million men and women in this earth, therefore what you see is different from 47 million. What your fingerprint is unique. That means you are fearfully and wonderfully made. Therefore, your life is unique. You cannot be compared to your neighbor, cannot be compared to your brother or sister, cannot be compared to anybody next to you, cannot be compared to your friend. You are uniquely given assignment, and your assignment from God is unique. That's what God has given us, unique assignment. We must accomplish our assignments. So don't compare yourself to anyone. You are never comparable. No one, believe me, even husbands will tell you, oh, I can't compare. Let me tell you, if you marry your wife or your husband, you can never compare them to any other woman. Why? You believe with me, and believe you with me, even those who have divorced. Let me tell you, you can never get a woman like that. That's a unique. Every woman is unique by their design. Their women are never the same. Please, never compare people. You think that is better? You'll die searching. Believe you me, life is unique. And God has given us a unique life in the name of the Lord. Now, remember this. Remember, a dreamer will never possess anything until he steps forward. A dreamer will never possess anything until they step forward. That means you can never be a possessor until you take a step. I pray today, may you be a man or a woman who will take a step. A journey of 1,000 miles is declared by a step. One step makes a difference. Today, I leave you with that word. Make a step in your life. Make a step in your destination. Make a step in your life that you shall step ahead and never look back. Never look back. Remember the story of Sodom and Gomorrah. Don't look back. Don't turn back. Go forward and forward ever in Jesus' precious name. Father, I bless your people, Lord, that they have heard what I've spoken this morning. I pray that their dream shall not abort. They shall not abort their dream, not their vision, not even what, Lord, you have given them. Give them the grace and the power to accomplish everything that they have decided to accomplish in 2020. That 2020 still, even if there are difficulties, we shall be able to overcome. I pray for your anointing. I pray for your blessing. In Jesus' name I pray. Amen. God bless you. As you continue, continue looking forward. Continue manifesting God's presence in your life. And your life will never be the same again. God bless you as God keeps you. In Jesus' name.